Over in the upper chamber, Senate President Francis Escudero allaying concerns on a possible stalemate over the 2025 budget due to the issue with the funding of the OVP. Our very own RG Crew is on the line now with details. RG, what more can you tell us?
Hi, Carmina. Good afternoon. Senate President Francis Escudero calms down talk of a stalemate between the House and the House of the Senate and the House of Representatives over the 2025 budget because of wrangling over the Vice President Sara Duterte's office budget next year. The Senate chief also downplayed concerns that the office of the country's second highest official would be defunded or given zero budget. The country's third highest official also held the belief that the Vice President wouldn't want her programs defunded. Escudero maintained that any impasse on the budget process can be resolved by voting on the matter. The Senate chief urged all concerned to respect the legislative process on the budget, as he maintained that the drama does not help the country in any way. On Tuesday, the Vice President's ally, Senator Ronald De La Rosa, said he sees a stalemate between the Senate and the House over the 2025 office budget of the of Sara Duterte. Now that because he believes that many of his colleagues will stand by her office budget now that she is supposedly being ganged up on by Congressman De La Rosa, refused to say that the Vice President is wrong for skipping the House hearing on her agency's budget, but he appealed to all that they understand why she chose to skip the hearing altogether. De La Rosa said it is up to the Vice President to decide if she will send representatives instead. Asked if he sees the tension between both chambers over the budget, De La Rosa answered affirmatively and asked again if this could lead to a reenacted budget for next year. De La Rosa explained that the reenactment will affect the whole budget, as the government cannot reenact just the OVP's budget. So it's quite likely that the whole budget will be caught in between. De La Rosa also rejected giving the OVP zero budget since they have to pay salaries for OVP staff. De La Rosa believes his colleagues will simply stand by, giving the OVP budget the courtesy that it has been accorded in past years, adding that there are numbers in the Senate in that direction. He answered also affirmatively when asked if he believed that congressmen are ganging up on the Vice President. He also dismissed criticism that the Vice President acted like a spoiled brat. Before that, Senate Minority Leader Aquilino Pimentel III also sought sufficient budget, in quotes, for the office of the Vice President. He said that giving the OVP the sufficient budget to carry out the VP's constitutional role or responsibility to be ready to be president at any given second. According to Senator Pimentel, OVP should have budget for staff, office, utilities, library, briefings, meetings, attendance and conferences, travel, both domestic and international. That's what he said in a statement to the media yesterday. Carmina?
Thanks a lot. RG Cruz there joining us on the line. The Philippines and China hold talks once again to manage tensions in the West Philippine Sea. Philippine Foreign Affairs Undersecretary Teresa Lazaro and her Chinese counterpart Chen Xiaodong met in Beijing Monday. The two agreed to continue the two countries' hotline mechanisms as well as discuss cooperation between their respective coast guards. China has been claiming parts of Philippine waters, resulting in multiple boat ramming incidents that endangers the lives of Filipino personnel. President Marcos branding as fake news rumors that Defense Chief Gilberto Teodoro has quit his post. Jervis Manahan joins us now with details. Jervis, go ahead.
Yes, Carmina, there is no truth to the circulating rumors in social media that Defense Secretary Gilbert Teodoro has resigned. President Bongbong Marcos said this is just fake news being spread by people who have the malicious intent to sow discord among Filipinos. Marcos said he has no problem with Teodoro, who is at the helm of the country's Defense Department. Rumors about Teodoro's resignation surfaced among social media platforms and are being circulated by anonymous accounts. Marcos urged the public to be very careful in the consumption of information they get online.
Fake news.
Even the Department of National Defense and the Philippine Communication Office issued separate statements saying there is no truth to the rumor as the faith of President Marcos, Teodoro has never wavered. The two agencies say Teodoro is still focused on boosting the country's capability of protecting our territorial integrity. Carmina Marcos attended a gathering of fisherfolk in Navota City today, where he led distribution of cash aid to people affected by the oil spill. Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Jervis Manan, there joining us on the line.